How good is Have You Been Paying Attention, right? It's hilarious. It's the hilarious quiz show right here on 10 that doesn't seem to mind having a laugh at our expense.
Tristan was missing from Studio 10 this week. What was the reason?
Carrie-Anne got her.
got her?
I don't know.
Tristan's the man.
Tristan, of course, you met Ed earlier this year on Dancing with the Stars, where you gave him some pretty clear advice.
You're doing the right things, you're just not doing them right at the moment.
Do you know what? It sounded better in my head. But...
What has got to stop? Tony.
Studio 10?
He's hot. She was thrilled to be on the show, I'm sure.
What are you going to do with local content quotas then, huh?
There we go, yeah. And I'm sure panellist Ed Kavalee is thrilled to be on our show too. He joins us now live. Good morning, Ed. Great
hey,
to see
Ed.
You.
Ed.
It's always a pleasure, you two. I would like to distance myself from the comments of those uninformed fools. You know that I'm a huge Studio 10 guy. I've bought two steam mops while I've been waiting to come on this morning.
Of course you have. You Have Been Paying Attention is back for another season.
What did you just call it?
Have you been paying attention?
No, you called it You Have Been Paying Attention. What is this?
I was making sure that you were paying attention. That was the gag.
Yeah.
No? It's back for another season. We absolutely love it. However, are we still going to be giving you content this coming season, Studio 10? Are we going to be the butt of your jokes?
We need the promo spots, to be honest with you.
I can guarantee that there was already, we filmed last night, there was a mention of Studio 10. And it was in relation to Tom Gleisner's age and the fact that he is, the only thing that he's now old enough to do is host our show or be in your audience. Those are the only two.
Joke's on you. We don't have an audience anymore.
Well, they're very quiet. They're very quiet.
Well, that's it. Thanks, Ed.
All the best, mate.
Good to see you both.
Bye.
Thank you for having me. See the Logies.
Tell us, you actually seem to know you. I've sat next to you on that panel a couple of times, and you know your stuff. Where do you get all your kind of your news fix from?
Well, I do, as you know, I do breakfast radio, Hughesy and Nairn with on Today FM. So, and as you guys know, doing this show, that you get osmosis. You don't want to know these things, but they creep into your head. So, at any given time, I know which basketballer the Kardashians are ruining the life of. I don't want to know these things, but sadly, I do. My favourite moment ever on Have Been Paying Attention. Tom asked a serious question. He said, "Oh, they found something in the ground in Western Australia that's never been found before," and obviously, you know, Sam buzzed in very unkindly and said the remains of Clive Palmer. But then the answer was a dinosaur that had been discovered for the first time in Western Australia, and none of us knew it. We were all just sitting there waiting for him to give us the answer, because when the questions get serious, that's when we're lost. And people always say to me, how come you win? Why do I win all the time? Tristan, Sarah, you've been there. These people are not smart. This is Kitty Flanagan. The woman took a cat on a holiday with a camper van. This is not Mensa we're dealing with. These are some of the dumbest people in the whole world. Sam Pang failed NAPLAN last week. These are not intelligent human beings.
Ed, you are our favourite panellist. Of course you are. Joining you tonight, our guest panellists, Kitty Flanagan, Aaron Chan and Anne Edmonds. If you're a judge on the show, who would your favourite be?
Oh, we're getting to this, are we?
Yeah.
I'm glad you brought this up because I am still unhappy with you, MacManus. Dancing with the Stars, you were the only one that liked me. When we were rehearsing, you came in and was sort of helping me with my chicken legs and my awful frame, but you could have given me a 10. Sarah, he could have given me a 10 anytime he wanted, but he did not. He gave one to Celia Pakola. She is known as being desperately unco. She will admit that, right? She gave one to Bo Ryan for his shirtless antics. Here I am sitting there giving it everything I've got, and I'm getting 7s and 8s like I'm an AFL footballer. It was a disgrace.
I gave them 10s. I gave you life experience.
That is true. No, my favourite, I'm on record as saying this, is my favourite is Sam Pang, and I don't like those people who say he's just there for diversity. That is not the truth, okay? Sam Pang is there. Sorry, I'm getting something in my ear. He is there for diversity. Thank you so much.
Do you guys wind each other up? Hey, you're speaking about Bo Ryan being shirtless. Yeah. I'm surprised you've got a shirt on today, mate, because you're on the front cover, star of Men's Health
Holy moly.
You're looking fantastic. What sort of prep goes into something like that?
Well, obviously, my wife, Tiffany Hall, was on the cover of Women's Health, and she's got TXO Life, which is her fantastic fitness program. And so I eat that food. So she wants to... Look at that. Look, holding that
amazing
rope.
And, this was the first, right?
Yeah, she's the first ever pregnant woman on the cover of Women's Health, and I was the first ever Scientologist on the cover of Men's Health. Big shout out to Xenu. Thank you for coming down and showing us all the way. She said to me, I'm doing Women's Health and you're going to do Men's Health. I said, no, thank you. I'm too, I've got weird things. I don't want to take my shirt off. I don't want to do that, please. And she said, I respect your wishes. And the next day she sat me down and she said, the good news is I've agreed that you're doing Men's Health magazine and you're doing it in 3.5 weeks.
Wow.
So the first thing I did was I went and bought a lamp from Pete Evans, $20,000, and that got me in shape. And then I worked with Clive Palmer's personal trainer, and then I got a spray tan, and then I was on.
Was it BYO olive oil for the shoot? Did you oil yourself up for the cameras?
No, weirdly, Melissa Leong volunteered to come and do it on the day.
You're like a big lamb roast.
You look fantastic, mate.
Yeah.
Great to see you're not skipping leg day anymore either. They're looking healthy.
Oh, you are just... I watched you backstage at Dancing with the Stars. You had one step to do, and I saw you, this is true, Sarah, smashing his knees back into place before he did his dance on Dancing with the Stars.
He does this before the show.
What are you going to do, huh? I just love dancing. That's how much I
love
dancing.
What are you going to do? I just love dancing. The Tristan MacManus story. You heard it here first. That is fantastic.
Dance like no one's watching, Ed. There's some more
of us.
Well,
I danced and a lot of people watched and they wish they hadn't.
Now, a brand new season of Have You Been Paying Attention? We can't wait. It airs tonight at 8:40 on 10 and 10 Play On Demand. Ed, thank you so much for joining us. We'll catch you soon. Hey, love that beautiful
missus
of yours.
Love you both. See you soon.
Good night.